everybody. So this is gonna be a little bit of a break from the previous two presentations. It'll be a concrete example of a solution, which is always fun. A lot of times these events are very high level and they don't really go down into the weeds of a solution. So this will hopefully be a nice break for that. So optics, creative intelligence. Very briefly, this started out as a collaboration with Google's GTech team. They came to us and said, hey, we've been playing around with the Vision API. We would love to see if there's a way that we could work together to come up with a way to use AI and machine learning to influence creative design and development strategy. So that's what we did. As a brief overview, the Vision API basically can take an image and take the unstructured data that is an image file, translate it into a structured entity with specific features for an image. Some of the examples that can come out are face and sentiment detection, so specific facial expressions and their likelihood. It can find objects in an image, dominant colors, plenty of other things as well. These are just some of the big key ones. So so creative intelligence, right? We run ads in Campaign Manager. Campaign Manager facilitates running ads. So there's image resources in Campaign Manager. We use Dataflow to extract these images and their performance. We run the images through the Vision API and then output the structured data in BigQuery for analysis. Pretty straightforward pipeline. Dataflow just allows for running all this parallelly and it goes much, much quicker. So like a real world example of how you might use this in ad creative is identifying objects. So we see we have two shoes and four shoes in each ad. Being able to identify the number of objects of a specific product that you're offering, and maybe there's a performance lift with running different quantities of the product in the ad. So just to give you like an example of how we would do this creative analysis, with every client that we run this with, we do a portfolio level analysis of all their creatives that are in Campaign Manager. So we'll run it through and we'll take a look at the performance lift of different features, having and not having those features. Our performance metric, just mostly for ease and how directly related to the specific creatives it is, we use an adjusted viewable click-through rate, which essentially clicks over total viewable impressions. We then split the creatives into two groups, having and not having a specific feature, and we run this across like all of the different data that comes out of the Vision API. And then we're able to bubble up the different features that are indicative of a performance lift, having and not having that feature. We're going to do a demo of the Vision API so you can see what the output looks like. So I'm going to have Liz help with that in the back. Yeah, so anybody can do this. It's cloud.google.com/vision. You can upload an image, scroll to the bottom, prove your sentience with a button click. And then it should output the results. Yeah, so here with this example, it's pretty standard lifestyle shot, right? We have the shoes and the image are outlined, so you get the specific location of different objects. And this is sent down with basically a bounding box around each feature. So then you might be able to do things like, where should like the products be in the creative, right? Like how prominently should they be featured? And then they have labels, right? So this is like, it obviously knows that it's a person, there's shoes, it can get the fur on the jacket. It's like all pretty cool stuff. It knows that he's sitting. And then it'll give you some relevant web entities. So basically these are linking to Google searches for specific components of the image. And finally the properties has some top level information about like the dominant colors and aspect ratios and things like that. Just some like pretty cool stuff, but in aggregate and at scale, you can do a lot with this. So if we can get back to the presentation. It's very large, there we go, hey. All right, that all went very swimmingly. we did an experiment with one of our clients, Deckers, specifically for their brand UGG. We wanted to see if there was a way to decide if like there actually was any difference in performance based on the number of products in a shot. You can see 2, 4, and 6 products. And then with the portfolio level analysis that we did, we found that most of their creatives had one or two shoes. Of the creatives with shoes, most had one or two shoes. But as you can see with the blue bars, that's the click-through rate. Click-through rate actually peaks past two shoes in the 3-4 range, and then quickly drops off, probably with just too much going on in the 5 and 6 range. So this is interesting, done at the portfolio level. But to really like prove out the efficacy of this test, we thought it would be worthwhile to do an A-B test. So we did an A-B test for 2, 4, and 6 and measured and ran a campaign, collected data, and then analyzed the results of the campaign. And we found that that 4 shoes had a 15% higher click-through rate than 2 shoes and 36% higher click-through rate than 6 shoes, which corroborates with our initial findings and then lends itself to have some higher confidence with the overall product that we're offering as creative intelligence. So then we wrapped all of this up in a case study, a couple slides. This one basically just goes over the initial goal that we had when we set out to work on this with Deckers, guiding product-based creative with object data analysis. And it just goes into the summary. We obviously looked at more than just the number of shoes when we did this test. It wasn't just like, all right, we're going to only look at shoes or the number of shoes. In addition to all of the base features that come out of the Vision API, we built our own features, like counting the number of models in the shot or where the shoes are. You can break down an image into sort of like a tic-tac-toe board and see where different products show up. Like, if it's a wide banner ad or a tall, skinny ad, like where should your products fit? And it can be different for every brand, right? So it just kind of goes over a very high level view of what that looks like. So at Jellyfish, we use data at every step of our business. With this tool, we're able to inform our creative decision-making processes for ourselves and for our clients. And with that comes increased performance with creative because we can steer the direction into guiding best practices or what they should do with their creatives. And then using this tool, we can also quickly and efficiently discover what works and what doesn't. So we're really excited about this solution. We've had a lot of success with it. It's exciting. It's a thought starter for new ways to approach creative, hopefully without stepping on the free spirit of the creative departments. Just another data point to get you thinking about new things. If you have any questions, happy to go into the solution or anything now, or you can find me afterwards. Okay, great. Thanks.